This is an Acer laptop from 2011. It has got i3 second generation, 2.3 GHz with 500 GB hard disk and 4 GB of DDR3 RAM. Now I am going to make some upgrades in this system. I am going to replace this 500 GB hard disk with an SSD. I have got a 128 GB of SSD. And it has got this 4 GB of RAM. As you all can see, this is a 2012 laptop with Windows 8 single language version, and so I am going to install Windows 11 in this laptop, and so I will be installing the Windows 11 home single language version so that the Windows gets activated. So let's start the Windows 11 installation process now. So this is my Acer laptop. Here is the HDD SSD 128 GB, as you can see here. Going to enter into the BIOS now. This is the SSD 128 GB. I have removed the hard disk now. I am going to install Windows 11 from the same USB that I used to install Windows 11. It has all Windows 11 restrictions like TPM secure boot and RAM check bypassed. So I am now going to boot from the USB, as you can see. So here is the Windows 11 boot operating from the USB. So here is the Windows 11 screen last time set up. And Windows 11 home single language ISO. It had already got partition. I will be deleting all of them now only. installing Windows 11 in this partition. So let's now start the Windows 11 setup. Almost 23% of the setup has been completed, and it's proceeding quite fast because of the SSD used. It's a decade old Acer laptop in the year 2012 with Windows 8 home edition. Percent of the setup has already completed. Not actually the setup, it's actually the main process which takes the maximum amount of time. It is copying the files to the SSD or the hard drive. Almost 97% and 98% now has been completed. Now it will ask for a system restart. Yes. these are the final steps. Actually, the Wi-Fi is in the other room, so I cannot get it connected now. I just connect the LAN. Actually, it is not catching the Wi-Fi signal well, because the proper drivers have to be installed. I have disconnected the internet so that it doesn't force me to use a Microsoft account. So this is the last and the final step for the installation. So the final setup has completed and it has booted to the desktop. I just now need to personalize the settings. Let's move to the task manager. It does not have much issues. It is not spiking the CPU or the SSD or the memory. It has i3 second generation and 4GB RAM, 64-bit Windows 11 home single language. Has already been activated because the original laptop came with Windows 8 home single language and we have upgraded it to Windows 11 home edition, so it has got activated. I did not need to install any crack or any key management systems. This one is the Windows 11 SSD and this one is the USB from where I installed Windows 11. So now I try to connect to my Wi-Fi. I have to go to the other room to connect it. So now I have managed to connect it to the Wi-Fi network. I also need to install the drivers from the driver pack. Now I am opening the driver pack solutions. so that the drivers can be installed. I have inserted an external hard disk from where this driver will be installed. It will actually install the Windows 10 drivers. It will also run on Windows 11. So the driver setup has already the hard job being completed, but it will take time to install the Intel HD graphics driver. So let's wait. It is taking time to install the Intel HD 3000 graphics driver. It generally takes time. A system restart may also be required. So it's asking a system restart. Not going to start the system. I'm still scanning for any missing drivers if any more is present. So now there are no missing drivers. And I need to restart the system now. So now all drivers have been installed. Now a few other things also need to be tested. First, I would like to lower the brightness. Sorry, it's lowering the sound levels actually. This one is actually decreasing the brightness of the screen. This one is okay for me. Opening Microsoft Edge and I will install Google Chrome. Although I use Microsoft Edge, but the user of this PC feels comfortable with Google Chrome. So Chrome has now been installed. scroll is working quite good, as well as this scroll. This is two finger scroll, as you can see. Here is the working of the two finger scroll, and here is the scroll working. So YouTube videos play also quite smoothly. So it has got no issues in running YouTube Full HD. Also view this video in full screen mode.
However,
screen. It has no issues in playing Bluetooth audience. Sound is very low. It has got no issue in playing YouTube videos. Let's test it with a few games. I am first testing Just Cause. It is a high graphics game and is running smoothly on this PC. It's very difficult to play these games using only the touchpad. However, this camera is quite smooth, as you can see. I have to update the DirectX library. Installing the DirectX now. Now the DirectX setup has been completed. So it can also run any post firewall. Windows 11 with 4GB of RAM can run any post firewall quite smooth. It can also run NFS Carbon quite smoothly. So here we have shown how to install Windows 11 in a decade old Acer laptop with i3 second generation and 4GB of RAM.